In this video, we compute a definite integral of an even power of the tangent function. And my goal here is to do this without quoting any power reducing formulas. I want to use first principles on this. So the first thing I can do is split off a factor of tangent squared and use an identity on that. And we use the Pythagorean identity for tangent and secant. I can write tangent squared x is secant squared x minus 1. And this is advantageous because secant squared is actually the derivative of the tangent function. And that's going to give me the right differential to guess one of the antiderivatives that results. So I replace tangent squared using that identity. Then I'm going to distribute the tangent to the fourth to both those terms and break the integral apart. So we'll do a couple things at once in the next step. In the first integral, I notice that I have the derivative of the tangent function sitting right next to a power of the tangent function. So this sets me up to guess the antiderivative. That's 1/5 tangent to the fifth. In the second integral, I have an even power of the tangent function, but it's a smaller even power, so that gives me hope. And I'm going to split that into tangent squared times tangent squared and apply that same identity again. This time we'll skip a little more of the work. I replace one of the tangent squareds again with secant squared x minus 1. So we end up with an integral of secant squared x minus 1 times tangent squared x. In the next step, again, I'll do a couple things at once. I'm going to evaluate that first antiderivative across the limits of integration. And the tangent of pi over 4 is 1. The tangent of 0 is 0. So when I plug in the upper limit of integration, I just get 1 to the 5th in there. So 1/5, 1 to the 5th. When I plug in the lower limit, I get 0. The integral then breaks into two integrals. Again, I'm just distributing tangent squared to each of those terms. And I want to make a special note of the fact that I end up with a plus on that second piece because I had to distribute this factor of negative 1 out in front to both terms inside the integral before I split it apart. Now in the first integral, I have this situation again where I have the derivative of tangent sitting right next to a power of the tangent function. And I'll pop my differential back in there real quick. And this integrates to 1/3 tangent cubed on 0 to pi over 4. And then in my final integral, all I'm going to do is just replace tangent squared with secant squared x minus 1 one more time. When I evaluate this tangent cubed piece across the limits of integration, again, the upper limit gives me the tangent of pi over 4, which is just 1 to the third power. The lower limit gives me 0. Because the tangent of 0 is 0. In my second integral, each of these pieces is now a guessable antiderivative. Secant squared integrates to tangent. 1 integrates to x. And again, when I look at the lower limit here, that's the tangent of 0 minus 0, which is just 0. When I plug in the upper limit, I get the tangent of pi over 4, which is 1, minus pi over 4. Cleaning things up a little bit, I get a common denominator of 15 for all these fractions, and I get 3 over 15 minus 5 over 15 plus 15 over 15 minus pi over 4. And that adds up to 13/15 minus pi over 4. And we're done. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.